Hi, my name is Marlini. I'm going to show you how to make a butternut squash curry, also known as Wattaka curry or Wattaka curry in Tamil. So I've taken a butternut squash which was about double the size of this. And when you choose your butternut squash in the supermarket, make sure that before it starts to balloon out, the top bit has to be really large. So you can just cut that and there won't be any seeds to get rid of, and you can just use the top bit and it's quick and easy. But if you're going to use the whole butternut squash, then you get to the bottom bit, which is the ballooned out bit, and you have the seeds. So you have to de-seed them, which I shall do now. And don't worry if you've de-seeded your butternut squash and you still have a seed or two here or there. Don't worry, because it's fine. You can roast the seeds and eat it as well. So here I'm cutting my butternut squash into pieces that size, maybe an inch or 2.5 centimeters wide. I'm also cutting it slightly smaller than you normally would, so it cooks quicker. And finally, I just want to add that once upon a time, I bought a butternut squash. I left it, went away on holiday, came back after about 2 weeks, and I thought I'd have to throw the butternut squash, but when I cut it open, it was as fresh as a daisy. So I thought, there's something about butternut squash in the skin that it just preserves the inside flesh forever and a day. Since then, I've started using the skin as well in my curries, and previously I would actually peel it, but I don't do that anymore because I wanted to do exactly what it does to its own flesh, to my skin, keep it preserved. But so I'm just continuing to cut the rest of the butternut squash into pieces. Your tabletop will get a bit messy, but it's very easy to tidy up. You see? And then chop away. One last piece. Once you've cut open a butternut squash, you can't actually keep the rest of it in the refrigerator for too long. It starts to go off. But as I said, if you hadn't cut it open, you can keep it for almost a month without going off. So that's the last piece. The skin is tough, but it is doable. You either have to get a very sharp knife and use all of your muscle power, or get someone bigger than you to cut it for you. Okay, so that's a whole butternut squash cut. And here in my pan, I have about 6 onions chopped and fried in vegetable oil. So into these onions, I'm going to add some curry leaves. So I'm adding about 3 sprigs of curry leaves. Only because I have quite a lot of butternut squash to cook. And butternut squash and pumpkin are the same family, so in Sri Lanka you would use pumpkin, but here I'm using butternut squash. And I've taken a whole leaf of pandan leaf and chopped it into sizable pieces. I'm putting a lot more than I normally would because it's a very large curry and we need that. And then I will add also 2 whole green chilies cut into pieces, and then the lemongrass, 2 thumb size pieces going in there. And then to that I will add about 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, whole mustard seeds, and it's a lot of butternut squash, so 2 teaspoons of turmeric. And 2 teaspoons of garlic, 1 teaspoon of ginger, both minced. And to this I will add 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. This butternut squash curry is very fragrant and it's a luscious taste. So that's cinnamon, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. And this is paprika, toasted paprika, 1 teaspoon. And this one is cardamom, that's ground cardamom, going in there, about 1 teaspoon.
And last but not least,
about half a teaspoon of cloves. Cloves are very important, so you wouldn't use as much as you would with the cinnamon. So that's half a teaspoon going in there. And now combine all the spices. It smells wonderful in here. It smells amazing, almost like you're in heaven. And now it's ready to receive the pumpkin, the butternut squash that I have cut. So in it goes. That is a lot of butternut squash. Here we go. Now I'm going to add some salt, 2 teaspoons of salt. And if it's not enough, I can always add a bit more later. So now I'm going to combine all of this together on very low heat. I'll make sure that every butternut squash piece is coated in this beautiful aromatic fried onion mixture, like so. And I'm going to leave it to cook in its steam for about a minute and come back to it to add some coconut, toasted coconut and coconut milk. So our butternut squash has been cooking now for about 5 minutes. So, oh, the fragrance is amazing. It smells so, so lovely. And it looks lovely too. So that's what it looks like at the moment. So it looks amazing. So ordinarily what you would do is toast some grated coconut, toast it, and then grind it and add it to this. But luckily here I have some organic coconut flour, so I don't have to grind it, but I'm just going to toast it just to release its rich flavors. So I'm going to toast it on that pot for about a minute or so. Keep an eye on it so it doesn't burn. While it toasts on this pot, into this I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of coconut cream. So it comes in a packet, you can just divide it into pieces like that. I'm going to add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of it. And just so the coconut cream starts to melt, I'm going to add about 2 cups of water. Remember, it's a lot of butternut squash. So 2 cups of water goes in there. And I combine everything. I'm keeping an eye on the coconut. Can you see how quickly it's browning? Just toast it like so. Once it reaches a slight golden brown, like it's trying to do now, keep turning it so you don't burn it. Be careful not to burn it. There we have the lovely toasted coconut flour, which I add. So I would say it has 1 to about 4 tablespoons of. Smells amazing. So I'm going to combine all of it together. It's the coconut cream, the 2 cups of water, and the 5 tablespoons of toasted coconut powder goes in there. Now I'm going to cover this and let it cook for about 15 to 20 minutes. I'm going to check at like 5 minute intervals to see if it's done. So I'm just checking the butternut squash curry in about, it's had 5 minutes. and it seems rather dry, and I do want these pieces thoroughly boiled, so I'm going to add another cup of water. I'm adding so much of water only because I'm using a very large butternut squash and it's a huge pot full, but otherwise you can get away with just one cup of water. So now I'm going to again flatten it so they all get submerged in the water in its own lovely gravy, and cover and let it cook for a further 10 minutes. So our butternut squash curry has had its 15 minutes, the last 15 minutes of cooking, and it looks luscious, it looks amazing, and the whole place smells lovely. I'm just absolutely transported to Sri Lanka when I get these flavors. It's lovely. So it comes off the flame because the butternut squash is cooked. Time for a taste test. It's lovely. You can do with a little bit more salt, so I'm going to add maybe another teaspoon of salt. I mean, if you find that your curry doesn't have enough salt, add salt like you would add salt to your chips, because that way you know that it's not going to be too much. So I turn this. And this curry is lovely. You can eat it with roti, rice, toast, absolutely anything at all. And my videographer, Rosie, doesn't like eating. She has an aversion to vegetables. And this is the only vegetable that she eats. So same with Ryan, so I've made a little bit more than I normally would. So just again. Delicious. The curry leaves, the pandan leaves, the lemongrass flavors are coming through, the onions. I can actually taste and feel the coconut, toasted coconut. The butternut squash itself is beautifully cooked through, and it's delicious, absolutely delicious. So if you enjoyed watching this video, I would really recommend that you buy butternut squash and cook, or even pumpkin and cook it. You will love it. Cook it for your family, for your friends. They will love you for it. And thank you for watching. Bye-bye.